I'm here, I'm about to take you higher. We about to set this bitch on fire. Pour a little gas, spark up your lighter. She might not be the one, but you the one that I desire. Come here, I'm about to take you higher.
Boom.
Boom.
Welcome to the NSFW show. What number is this? Like eight?
Eight or nine.
We should
let me drive the boat.
16. Huh? We should preface that if you are not a fan of explicit language, this is probably not the episode for you. I feel like that's a good idea going forward with these.
With these? I mean, to be fair, the last one, I put a little parental advisory in a little Bing. John.
If that's Bing, something that you are also, not comfortable with, just don't watch this
skedaddle.
Episode.
Yep, look at Darian's face right there. Bing! Parental advisory, look at my face right here.
All right.
Bing!
Question of the night. All right, so look. We were just in the kitchen.
The wrist flipping?
Yeah.
It's not a question.
It's not, I mean, it is a question,
it's
I think.
Not.
It's question. More like a hyperbole.
Anthony, stay right there. Don't you move.
Don't you
move. Don't you Irish goodbye. All right,
so look. So Kevin.
Oh, yeah. There's actually all six of
wait,
us
no,
are
no,
here.
No, no. It's me, Jake, and Kevin on a team versus X, Anthony, and Brian. 3v3
basketball.
Who wins?
Yes. Literally
I think
just
it's a sound
comment.
Matchup.
Comment right now.
I think it's a real sound matchup.
I think whoever set that bracket, and mind you, I'm probably the
let's
least.
Let's break it down, though. Let's break it down.
I'm the right, least weathered baller in the room. Oh, shit. I keep
go ahead,
kissing
Skip.
The mic.
Go ahead, Skip. What do you think? How are you analyzing this matchup? How do you think the game would play out?
Well, see, if we're looking at this objectively, right?
Mm-hmm. Obviously. It's going to be Ant.
Is that your douchebag analyst voice?
Yeah.
Hand too.
It's going to be Ant.
Can I get more cigar smoke?
And it's going to be Darian.
Years of smoking in there?
if you're looking at this objectively,
popcorn lung.
So if we're looking at this objective, right?
There we go.
No. It's going to be Ant. It's going to be Darian,
yeah.
Right? It's
going to
be.
One.
I would assume it's got to be Kev. It's got to be Brian, right? That would make the most sense.
Probably.
It's going to be me and it's going to be Brian. I mean, it's bad news bears for either of you.
I think it's going to switch at some point. Like I think it'll go, the brothers will go against each other. And you will
y'all going to see, y'all about to feel my wrath, son.
I'm telling you, bro.
I'm really a baller. We could have did anything else. Like we could have played pickleball. We could have played lacrosse.
I would have been down for whatever. We could have went and saw Zbyskies on the ice or something.
I think this is
it.
I think this is the best matchup. This is the best.
I think it's fair, though, because Brian's a good basketball player.
It was getting hot in there. When did that happen?
Brian's tough. Brian's aggressive.
He's aggressive.
He plays hard in the paint. He's been training for years.
He plays like it's fucking rugby.
He's got a big heart.
I know. What was your reference? He said he played like the 95 Bulls or some shit. Like
The Pistons.
The Pistons. Brian's out there just setting
boy Pistons. Yeah.
Yeah.
I do. I set a lot of screens.
Do you? Yeah, you guys love basketball.
Like legal,
so we're talking about doing this Saturday at 11 a.m. At an undisclosed.
Be
location.
There.
Yeah, we're gonna have it. Be there. Be square. Yeah, we
don't
should.
Be
just
there.
Someone's
big
gonna
ass.
Duck. Someone's gonna duck. Something's gonna happen.
Quack.
Xavier's gonna be like, bro.
I'm just wanting to know who
quack.
It's gonna be.
Quack.
I mean, realistically, three of us live here. So if we all wake, one of us wakes up. No one has an excuse to duck. I'll start.
Wait a minute. I'm ducking. I have plans on Saturday at 11.
Oh.
That's crazy. Yo, all I gotta do is get my hair cut.
And it's crazy because
that
I was just gonna say that was 4K. I mean 1080p on this end, but that's 4K
He's
over
been
there.
He's talking
so.
About ducking for the past 20 minutes.
I know, and
pod,
he was
too.
The main one. He set this up. He initiated. Now he's gonna try to reschedule the haircut.
Quack.
He's like, damn. Quack. Quack.
The what's a haircut?
The Barnes and Noble's date got get pushed back.
Let him go.
Oh,
it's a haircut. I got the same shit on Monday.
Yeah. I know. Speaking of Monday, we got a big ass pod on Monday too. What are we doing here?
We got a big day in the pool.
Are you
going to
be here for that?
Now?
Oh, yeah, we do. Jake, me and Jake have a swim workout Monday.
Wait.
We have a pod on Monday.
Yo, don't care yourself because, bro, it's like you will be dead after that.
Well, no, I get it. But what I was just talking about too is like, and I need you here as well because if I got to bear through this, you got to bear through this. What do we do about this Birds game? Because that's going to be like, that sucks.
I mean, it sucks for you. That's just going to be on my phone.
I mean, honestly,
I'm
bro,
corner.
If the pod starts at 7, we have a whole hour. Like,
yeah,
you guys
but
can just like.
I would never want to cut the pod short though, like to rush to like watch the game.
But
that's
the game
seeing,
doesn't
like,
start till 8:15.
Yeah,
and it probably will start till 8:30.
Oh, it starts at 6.
The pod starts at 7. The game starts at 8:15.
That's valid though. The game probably won't.
So
start
we're gonna miss like the first. I'm gonna miss like the first quarter and a half. Probably.
Well, then maybe just like you know how we usually like mess around like no, we don't mess around but, like for the first like 15 minutes we'll sit there maybe just cut that like.
Was Good Buddy supposed to get here at 7? Yeah. Or are we supposed to start at 7?
He said he's gonna get here at 7.
Fuck.
I mean, like I said, dude, we're off all day. We could maybe figure something out.
Yeah, but I already rescheduled with him twice.
Fuck me. And I will say, I mean, it's not a big deal, but Monday I worked till like 3. So, like,
either way, yeah, we would have needed the kid.
I mean, granted, you could just say, hey, if you could do 6, yeah, we would love to do 6.
The thing is, we'll already be an hour in if all goes well, and we could be proactive in making sure that it goes well.
What do you mean?
Like, if it starts at 7, we'll be golden. We'll have an hour and 15 minutes.
I mean, it just is what it is at this point. I mean, if it's going to happen, it's going to happen. There's really no, like, making it work.
You guys have to understand, like, you know, from your guys' point of view, this might, like, look bad on Kevin. You have to understand, this might be the last playoff game the Eagles are in for the next 5 years.
You got to understand, I'm a diehard Birds fan. Okay. So, like,
how can we reschedule this this basketball game? That's more what I'm worried about. Not reschedule, but, like, what can we do? Can we push it back to noon? Because like Jake was saying.
No, but don't say noon because a haircut is not an hour. You know that. You're not going to be there for an
hour. That's a good point. You're going to NYO?
45,
yeah.
An hour 45.
Yeah, you're going to be in that lobby for a little while. You're
gonna
be
I'm not going to be in the lobby.
No, actually not.
I'm going to be right in the chair.
I'm gonna say NYO, you almost never wait. Really? Bro, when I got NYO, I'm in there in like 5 minutes.
No, shout out NYO.
The haircuts take a while though, but like they're good haircuts. So I mean, it is what it is. But yeah, it's not gonna be an hour.
You're gonna chop it up with Jose. You're gonna catch up with him.
For me, the best scenario would be move it to Sunday.
That would be the best scenario.
Yeah, bro. I can't do Sunday, and I'm also gonna be feeding football Sunday too.
Let's do seven. noon 30.
Noon 30.
I'm sorry. Is that a time?
Yeah.
I mean, technically,
anything's a time. You know how many words Shakespeare invented?
You know how many words are invented?
12.
That's incorrect.
No, it's actually an insane amount.
It's like over 100 words.
It's crazy.
He invented the word upstairs.
Wait, no, didn't he?
No, he didn't.
Fuck around.
No, he did.
No, he did.
Fuck around.
Upstairs.
He did. Bro, some of them invented some fuck of the around. Ones.
Upstairs.
No, Vince Mergazza invented fuck around.
Fuck around. Yeah. Find fuck out. Around. Wasn't every word invented?
Oh, wait. Did everyone, we don't have to do them now, but did everyone find something interesting to talk about?
I got a couple things. No. I wouldn't say any of them are too interesting. I knew Jake wasn't going to.
That's funny. I knew Jake wasn't
going to. I knew Jake. I guarantee you his ass didn't.
No, he definitely did.
No chance you did.
No,
bro.
I knew
he
that.
He came to my room and said, yo, you should think of some things that I were.
No,
I
it's to. Actually funny because in my head, I was like, I know Brian's going to have one thing because like when you ask Brian to do something, he says he's going to do it. He probably will. I knew neither of these two were. I just knew that.
Dude,
was
do you actually
happen.
Not have anything?
Bro, I have something.
He don't got nothing.
Let's see it right now.
He,
right,
you're going to see him in 2 minutes. He's going to be down here like this.
Interesting mine, things to
was?
Talk about.
Yeah, what's yours?
It was riddles that I asked AI to give me for men around the ages of 20 to 30 years old.
Okay. Interesting. Okay.
But they really weren't that good at riddles. It ended up becoming like paradoxes, but.
Well, paradoxes are cool. I like paradoxes.
Yeah.
Give me a paradox and I'll solve it for you right now.
I don't think
that's how it works.
It's not at all.
That's how it works.
It's the exact.
Then again, sometimes I hear paradoxes and I'm like, well, no, just be.
Well, I didn't really like the way that the riddles turned out though. So I'm not too proud of what I brought to the table. But.
Which came first?
Nonetheless, the chicken or the egg?
The egg.
Egg.
It fell from the cosmos.
So, riddle one. I am a paradox, an enigma, wrapped in mystery. I travel the world without moving an inch, speak without uttering a word. People seek me, yet when found, I am often lost. What am I?
I might have missed half of that on accident.
Yeah, run that back.
Run it back just one
more
time.
Say it slowly.
I am a paradox.
All right, so he's
a without an accent.
Wrapped in mystery.
We got that.
I travel the world.
Okay.
Without moving an inch. Speak without uttering a word. People seek me, yet when found, I am often lost. What am I?
The egg. The
oxygen?
Chicken.
I don't know.
The egg. He's the egg.
So how's that for being prepared?
All right? Answer?
No.
Question?
No.
The problem with that preparation, though, is like we're all about to sit here like idiots.
For yeah, I know. That's seconds. Yeah, that's true. Because we're just gonna sit and ponder.
Yeah, just.
But Brian's real. He likes riddles, so I thought I'd accommodate.
No, Brian's a big riddle guy.
I mean,
what do you think, Brian? What is he? My guess is the egg. Brian, he's the egg.
You're not even taking it serious, and I don't appreciate that.
Whoa!
Because
I was the only one that answered.
I threw out like four answers.
You didn't throw a legitimate answer.
That was a legitimate answer.
No, it wasn't. How is egg actually relevant to that question?
Because I think it almost applied to everything you said besides the last sentence where.
Okay.
How does an egg found or some shit like that
apply to being lost?
Can you show me the question? Like, can you show me the question without the answer?
The answer's right underneath it.
Are not every single egg you bought in theory lost? Because can you find its owner?
Boo.
Yeah. You're just working at things, and
it's the riddle. I mean, this is what riddles are.
You don't
are,
believe
no?
that's Boo. The answer. Like, you're not. I you mean, don't have conviction.
No, but if I were to actually sit here, like I said, and pondered it out,
You wouldn't
you
have
probably
said
would have lost me from the pod for a little while.
Right, yeah, that's honorable.
Can you please read it one more time?
One more
just,
time?
Just one more time. Because if I don't get this one, then I'm never going to get it.
That like, popped into my... Only. Yeah, I'm mad not one of you three caught that either because Hawthorne. Only the real one should remember that.
Yo, what is Hawthorne from, X? We should have got him a mic. We don't have a...
The Hawthorne!
What's the Hawthorne from? Yo, Anthony, trivia question. What's the Hawthorne from?
You better know. I'm going to be upset.
Brian, can you say it in your accent? Because you were the one saying it pretty much all night. You don't know either? No.
The Hawthorne! No,
but you said I was the one saying it all night?
Yeah, you coined that term.
No, you did.
Wait.
You don't even know. See, this is crazy.
You guys are some glazed biscuits.
Why are you? No, because Ant's off camera looking at
do
me.
Do you
like,
know?
Of course I know, all bro. Right,
good.
That's one of my best experiences.
Look at well, just,
well.
Should we even tell them?
There's two tabs open right now. One's a riddle, one's the Hawthorne.
No, because now if I'm now I
want to
know. Oh!
Oh, you got it.
Wait, bro. I was trying to. Me and Aaron were trying to figure out this what I was saying the other day for like an hour, or at least I was. I don't know.
Where were we?
But I kept on trying to think of other hotel names, and I couldn't think of ones. The Hawthorne. Oh my god! Yes, I know that's right.
The only reason that shit popped into my head is because I was at Jake's crib earlier.
It's from when we were at Salem. I was walking, there's a hotel called the Hawthorne.
No, Jake had cologne on his dresser called the Hawthorne. I thought that shit was hilarious.
Yeah, I was thinking we should on our Instagram page create stories of all of our travels. I think that'd be pretty cool.
Like actual stories in like the Johnny one?
Like you know how people will put like
write short
Columbia.
Stories.
No.
I got one of those on my personal page.
Yeah, we should do it on the IG page.
Yeah. It's like kind of that actually leads into like my first kind of main topic that I wanted to talk about. I have like one of those tabs on my Instagram page, but it's just for all like the like fun adventures and stuff that I go on. And that's kind of like what my topic was to get us talking because I know you and I have been talking about this a lot. And I think as a collective group, it could be all six of us or one of y'all or two of y'all could pansy out, whatever you want to do. We need to like really lock in an adventure. Like, we got to go on an adventure soon. Because, I mean, we just got back from an adventure, but I've been lusting for the adventure.
Me too.
I need the adventure again in my life. I don't know. I didn't settle back into the groove as well as I thought I would. So I think I really need to, like...
I mean, you know what we could do? You know, like, we went to Salem for a reason. But, like, we also just said, all right, let's just find somewhere to camp.
Yeah.
We did that, and that's kind of, like, what made it fun.
Yeah.
We did something in that... Like, realistically, we could... What's funny over there, buddy?
Yeah, buddy. What's so fucking funny?
Because Brian can blink like... Oh, right. My eyes are dry. I'm trying to like moisten them. Anyway.
You try to moisten the eyes.
That's a skill issue. I've never heard of such a
me either.
Listen, bro. This is what I'm staring at, right? I got a bright ass light. My eyes are getting dry.
L plus ratio.
But we could just go to another like state or something that's near like something simple, but we could just go to a state that's near us, like look up like the most interesting part of that state, go there, travel there, spend the day there, and then find another place to camp. Like I feel like it's simple, but like that's what made Salem so fun.
Yeah.
We went there.
I'm down for that.
We just fucked around.
Some camping.
Yeah. We were just talking about that.
Like I think one of the funnest parts was like, well, good. It was also like kind of nerve wracking because we were like, what if we get towed? Like, what if we get caught up here?
Yeah.
Like, fuck. But then like going to sleep on that beach and then waking up in the morning and like seeing like everything.
So cool.
That
was
so
awesome.
Beautiful.
So cool. He and I were just talking about that. Like, I mean, it sucks that it's January now. It's probably not the best time, but we should make going to Dead Horse Beach and camping on Dead Horse Beach like a thing that we do. Like,
yeah, that'd be fun.
The boys just link up. We go to Dead Horse Beach.
We definitely told you this and probably the pod too, but like we woke up and there was a fucking half marathon going on between clowns and devils. And like we literally woke up and literally 10 feet away from us down the hill was just people like in clown costumes and
that's
devils running a marathon.
Shit to
like,
wake up to.
We were just parked in the middle of the marathon. Yeah. Ryan just
I was brushing his teeth
in the middle of the marathon.
I'm like just brushing my teeth while clowns run by and I'm like, look, you can't leave the resting.
Spitting out the window and shit.
It
was funny too because I don't know if we ever talked about it. I don't know if we ever told you, but the initial plan because we wanted to sleep on the beach. We didn't actually sleep on the beach. We slept on like a hill right above the beach. Kind of.
I don't think it could have went better though.
No, it couldn't have went better. But initially,
Darren would have drowned us.
Yeah, Darren was going to drown us. Well, I wanted to initially too, but I just knew it wasn't going to work out. We wanted to sleep on the beach because the tide was really low at the time.
Very low.
We were thinking like, oh, like we might be all right. Like we could probably sleep on the beach and get away with it. We woke up. The water was all the way to like the rocks or whatever. Like,
that would have been a rude awakening.
Yeah, if we just got smacked by a wave in the middle of the night, imagine that. Like all of our, what would we have done? cold as shit. October morning.
A part of me just knew that like the sand would be wet, and I was like, it's gonna seep through the thing, and I'm gonna get soaked. I'm gonna be tight in the morning, so I didn't want to sleep on the beach at all. And that was the only thing that was keeping me like away from it the entire time. Was I'm like, I'm gonna be wet, bro. I don't want to be wet. Mm-hmm. I'm gonna be cold. That's not gonna be fun. So that was the only thing. Like me getting the water coming up was just like a thing that I said, oh, like. Because, you know, I try to think like logically. I'm like, logically, the water's not going to go that high. Yeah. We could go there, we'll be fine. But
that's
I'm
where
like,
I was at, too.
But nah. I'm like, nah, like, we got to, you know, because the water's going to come up real high, guys. And honestly, I was right, but I didn't believe myself.
I literally said the reason I knew that shit was going to happen is because the sand was already wet and there were seashells on the beach, like just out on the beach. So, I mean, obviously, the water was going to go up there at some point. That was awesome, though. We got to do something again like that. I want to see exactly what I wrote down, though, because I think it was just about adventures, but. That is something we got
to
do.
Yeah, I think that we could definitely make a day trip happen. There's tons of places to go in PA.
Yeah, well.
Yeah, for sure.
Woods.
Or literally just anything. I don't know what we could do. We got to do something different. And, like, what is something different we could do in the Barrie, though? Because I don't think we actually, like, we don't have to go somewhere crazy to do something like this. Like, what is something we could do here that's crazy?
There's a ton of cool places around here.
Yeah.
Really are. I feel like we just never, like, want to, like.
Doing it in your hometown kind of sucks. Like, it's like, fuck. Yeah, we're still in the Barrie. Like, when you're in Salem Beach Camp, it's like, like, we're in Salem right now.
Maybe it's like Salem, just about the mindset.
I do, though. Too.
I like Salem a lot. Like, Salem the vibe there is super cool.
It's just, dude.
My bedtime.
The bedtime alarm, and here we are. 20 minutes into an NSFW pod. That's terrible.
So what'd you bring up? What'd you have?
Huh?
What'd you have?
Oh, no, it was literally just that. I just put needing adventure in my life, because I definitely think I do. I'm lacking adventure right now. I need to just do something.
Come back from a 2-week backpacking.
Yeah, but that's the problem. Like, you do crack once, you're gonna want crack again, and that's like
he's right.
That's like kind of where I'm at. Is like that was the fix, but now I'm like going through the adventure withdrawal. Like, if you really want to like put it into like,
I am too, man. I want to go do something again.
Yeah, and then I just put. What's something we can do to throw ourselves into the fire? Like, what's some fun shit we could do? Let's go get some capayas and fucking Wilkes-Barre.
What were you saying? I was trying to tell Brian the other day. You said some shit on the horse that made literally no sense, but it was just funny.
I said, I think it was just like
capayo, capayo.
Yeah, or some shit. Like it was some funny shit. I don't know.
I was just talking about that, actually. No, riding horses in Colombia was badass. That's some, like, let's go ride horses in Wilkes-Barre and just walk them shits around.
I'm a real stallion.
The great
myself.
Colombian fumble.
I know. That's we were. Hey, that's what we were talking about. The good. Hey.
Too crazy now.
NSFW. Xavier brought up a good point though, and like I don't know what we've been thinking. And I mean, I get it's probably better for the soul. And I think I was just saying this to you too. We've been sober for the last like 5 NSFW pods. We started this pod like with the intention that we were just gonna do stupid shit and like drink and smoke cigars and stuff, and we just haven't.
Were we sober? Nah.
The last couple we didn't. I had two beers.
Yeah, I definitely
you
got
drunk.
The last one I know we didn't drink.
No, maybe not. The one before that almost positive. Yeah,
I swear, because I was like just watching them, and I was just like going back and I was watching the last couple, and I could like at least I don't think the last like 2 or 3 we did.
No.
Brian had like the hard zonas.
I swear you got drunk with me because I think I was bringing up the Arizonas for me and you.
Yeah, but that was a grip ago.
That was like two or three ago.
I think.
Am I an asshole? Let me see.
I think you might be an asshole.
The last one that we did was the Shake Me Piggy episode.
That's funny. When you put on the mask earlier for the picks, I was like, he'd look fire with the Shake Me Piggy right now. I don't know why.
That is true. I gotta go get the Shake Me Piggy. It's still at my mom's house.
Jake moved out.
Yeah. I was just at Shields the other day.
Now.
Yeah, he did. That was one of the things I wanted to talk about too. Jake got that crib.
How's it feel, bro? Being independent.
It's nice.
Yeah,
it is nice. Yeah,
it's cool.
It's not too crazy about it, but like, it's nice.
Oh, I'm definitely.
Yeah, you were already
kind
of independent, like with your setup.
Yeah, I'm definitely a glazer.
Especially like with my schedule, my mom's schedule. Like, we didn't run into each other all that often. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
We was drunk as fuck on that part. I can't even lie.
Let me see.
I was definitely glazing. Literally not the last NSFW.
Oh, the one before it?
That's
Brian
what I thought.
The fucking Zonas.
That was the Arizona pod. The Zona Tees, baby.
God damn it. They caught me in a lie.
But I will say, I love Arizonas, and the Arizona Tees are okay. But like the alcohol. Arizona Tees, but like Arnold Palmer, like a million times better.
Brian's a.
Because like they're like lemonade mainly, but.
Brian's a pansy when it comes to drinking.
I mean, I guess so. I just don't like beer.
Just tweeze.
Actually, no. You're a pansy. Which more? I'd rather drink liquor than beer. But if I'd rather drink like sweet tea. Like sweet.
That's
tea
a problem. Like we should
rather drink liquor than beer.
We should have started this pot with a different intention because none of us really drink like that. Besides like Jake, because he's a bartender.
Yeah, Jake gets drunk on the job every single day.
That is not true.
On the job every single day.
Every single day.
I'm actually there every single day.
If you buy him a drink, he'll drink
not
three of them.
True. I'm there every single day to witness this too, so I know. Is he a jobaholic?
Let's actually, yeah, because Kevin and Brian both know this because they're at my bar at work every single day getting absolutely shit-faced.
Whoa.
They're both raging alcoholics.
I'm sorry. Can you prove that? Is that fake news? Can you prove that?
Prove that for us, please.
Yeah, can you please? What was La Cantina, right? The spot we were at.
That place is tough.
Yo, that's the new HQ. You missed out. La Cantina. You missed out because
I saw it today. I was around that area today.
They blessed up too. Like the food, immaculate, dog. And then she came out. We were about to leave because we were holding them up.
She's like, wait.
Yeah, so we got about there. The lady come running out. She was like, wait. And we were like, whoa, what? She came out bearing gifts. She came out with a fat ass bucket of churros. She was like, so. We make these churros fresh every day, and if we don't get rid of them by the end of the day, we typically just throw them out anyways, but they're really good, and if you guys want them, you can have them. So she gave us a whole tray of just churros after what might have been the most monumental Jargon Bond Marsha Klang in recent history, right?
Yeah.
I mean, if I'm not mistaken.
We need more of those.
That was a sturdy one.
It was. I mean, me and Jake got one in a pretty lethal one today.
Yeah, we did.
As well. Heavy, son. Hurting. Yeah. I was benching, 195 for 8 reps? That was fucked. I haven't done that, I don't think, ever.
95 8 reps.
What do you think your max is at right now?
I don't know.
I asked him that
too. My max is low right
that
now.
That was my first time benching in a long time. We were lifting heavy today. I was like shoulder pressing 60s. I don't think I've ever done that either.
I couldn't even put up the 135 for 8 today. Yeah, I was rough today.
I could drop 225. It's not true, but I'm
yeah. That's like your what would you call that? That's like your gym pillar. Like if you don't go to the gym and bench the 235, like you, how do you feel in the brain if you
225? Well, listen, buddy, I haven't hit 235 yet, so.
You never benched 235?
No, I benched 230 once. Well, I mean, fair. I benched 225 for two my first time hitting
yeah.
it.
So, yeah. I haven't benched 225 or two in a long ass time, but then Jake and I have seen probably four different people in Danko City that was benching like over.
The
like
one guy was putting up 315 for 10 with his legs in
yeah,
the air.
Yeah, with his legs in the air, like.
315 for 10 reps.
We're about to have a power lifter on the pod.
What does that make it
yeah?
Monday. Yeah.
I don't think so. Oh, I've tried. I will.
Oh, is it the dude from Danko's?
Yep.
Yeah.
Really? I'm excited to ask him some things. Yeah.
Who, Mr. Danko?
No.
Oh, I was
going
to say.
Different conversation. Sorry. Anthony said that if you put your legs in the air when you bench and you do it the right way, apparently it makes it easier.
Yeah, what do you mean that's by the right way, though?
Bro, I don't know. I trust Anthony with almost anything. I can do more. Yeah, lay on the fucking table.
You're basically doing.
You're saying you're basically doing decline when you put your legs in the air like that? Really? Whoa. That's strange. I think like part of the reason I bench as heavy as I do is because of like my ability to drive my legs into the ground.
Straight up in the air?
No, not straight up. So like, say my chair was the bench. He was like laying down, but his legs were like up here like this. Kind
of. Yo, you want to demonstrate in that camera?
No, yo, somebody point the camera at him.
No, that's good. That camera gets him.
There we are.
My camera probably never seen me in the flip.
Is he an old head?
Yeah, kind of.
The old heads will set up a decline on a flat bench and put up crazy weight, and the youngins are like, yo, that dude is insane, but really they're making
it. He was big as fuck,
I don't care, decline.
Yeah. He was big as fuck.
315 to 315, exactly. I don't care.
Decline,
I don't care. Old head, fucking decline, incline, flat bench. 315 is 315.
And then the one guy in there, like I was telling Jake, I was like, if you ever feel the need to put four plates on each side of that bar, like you got to take up a new hobby. I feel like play the ukulele or something. But why? I don't know. I wish I could. Maybe it's just my insecurity. Like maybe that's what that is.
What about a fitness
challenge? Right. That was actually another thing I wanted to talk about too. Yeah. Go Getters Fitness Challenge. What are we doing, boys? Let's talk about it right now.
We just got to chalk it up. Like it has to just be. We have to just be decisive with it. Like, what's it going to be?
I actually just said the other day when we were talking about this, I wanted you here because you're a fitness guy. So, like, we need your help figuring this shit out.
Yeah, we know. We also want you to participate.
Well, yeah, to participate as well, obviously. But, like, us four were together the other day, and I said, like, I think what we actually got to do, because there's too much pressure for me to think about this shit by myself. So I was like, we should all, like, sit down, just pick a day. It could be Saturday when we go to play basketball or whatever.
Well, no, I mean, you know what I think the problem is, though?
Huh.
I think, like, the reason that it's taken us so long, we're like, yeah, we'll do it, and then we don't do it, is because we all go, yeah, let's do something like the 75-day hard. But it can't be the 75-day hard. It has to be our own
thing.
That's
true. And that's where the conversation stopped.
It can't be too easy, though.
But
like, it has to be
like,
challenging.
Realistically, why don't we just use the 75-day hard as, like, a baseline and add or subtract things from there?
We could.
Because, like, if we keep going, it can't be the 75 hard, we're going to go, all right, well, we can't, like, do almost
76
anything like the 75
day hard.
You know what I mean?
Like, 76 days. That's a good idea.
Go. But I think that's the problem. I think we hear it can't be like 75 day hard, and then we just 75 day
well,
hard.
Well, Darian talked about like adding the plunge in there. Like we could do something like that.
But not everybody has access to a plunge. Though.
And a lot of people.
Dango's about to have one. We all have a Dango's membership.
No. But he's saying like this is also.
Oh, the people. Yeah, I get what you're saying. Jake, don't fuck with the plunge.
Don't fuck with the plunge.
Jake doesn't like anything that changes your bodily temperature. Jake, don't fuck with the sauna.
No, I don't like the sauna just because I don't like to have to fucking bring a change of clothes to the gym and like get in the shower. Like
you shower after the sauna?
Yeah.
You shower?
I don't want to sit. No, I figure like must in the car ride home.
No, what do you mean? Like a sweat is your own natural shower?
Yeah, it's like your natural bodily glaze.
So we're dicky.
No. Why do you think God gave us sweat?
Took me a second to understand.
It's like, why did God give us sweat, Jake? It's like. If he didn't want your body to be glazed, it's like, then why would you sweat?
And I mean, if you think about it, he wanted us to sweat so that we can cool ourselves down.
I'm sorry, are you a science teacher?
I'm not a science teacher.
Can you prove that that's why God did that?
That's like a reasonable hypothesis, and I'm sure that there's some research done on that. I think that's the best idea that we have.
Find one article.
I don't think you could talk to God and be like, yo, is that why you did it? I could probably find an article.
Find one article that proves
it. If I find an article, then what? Then what happens?
I agree with
you. Found the dick eating trap because that's crazy. Why? You're just letting him do this to you.
What?
You're just letting him do this to you.
What if I'm doing it to him?
Well, you're Googling right now. He's sitting here laughing.
This dick eating is getting a little
Google
bit meta for me.
Google is a funny word. I like Google. Brian, what's the most heinous word you can come away on the spot?
I don't know.
Is .org valid?
Gorgeous.
Huh? Is .org valid? Or
probably the most.
No.
.edu
is most valid.
.gov. .edu.
.edu.
It depends. Yeah. There might be some fake news.
Actually, which one? Ant's a fucking professional. WebMD. Whenever I look up some shit, he's like, let me see
Web
that
MD?
Bitch.
WebMD?
Yeah.
Dot fucking.
It's going to be like, if you sweat, you have cancer, and you're going to die.
Pull up Huberman. That's just going to say, if you sweat, you have COVID.
Oh, this, I'm surprised Ant didn't leave right there.
You don't like Huberman Lab?
Anthony hates everyone.
We should lock Anthony and Huberman Lab in a room together and see what happens. They would develop the next atomic bomb. what would they call it?
The Kaspenheimer.
Oh my God. We should just do a pod where we just binge watch Oppenheimer. I still haven't seen that movie.
He is the destroyer of worlds.
Yeah,
Kevin, by any chance, could me and Anthony borrow one of your cameras so we could make a reaction channel? Because he talks about reacting to things every 20 minutes.
That's how
we got the okay.
You're just going to set up a tripod and just watch Harry Potter?
Game of Thrones.
Game of Thrones.
You think we're joking? Every day, one of us
took that to heart.
We can react to it.
You can set up like the little...
Stolen
like
valor.
The OBS jump, the little... What do you call that fucking thing? The webcam window on the top right, and then you just have like the John playing on the screen. You'd probably get your channel taken down in like 3 days, but...
No, you wouldn't show the video, you just...
Fair use.
Fake news.
See, look, he's been studying.
Fake news. Yeah, I mean, he's probably actually been thinking about that.
And I'm joking about it, but you set it up, I'll do it with it.
Uh-oh. Now, what do y'all be getting into down there, though, is the real thing? Y'all just be binging? What about Suits? Are you guys watching Suits together?
No.
No? How is that? Well, no, I'm not even trying to glaze. I was actually about to ask, like, how is that show? Because I actually kind of really wanted to watch it.
I was watching it yesterday.
Suits
is really good. What is it called? Granted, I watched like 2.5 seasons straight, and now I'm kind of like suitsed out, but I recently saw a clip of it, and I was like, all right, let me get back into it. But it's very
good. That shit lived on my TikTok for so long, I feel like I got the gist of the whole show.
Yeah, that's what made me watch it. I saw a clip, and I was like, oh, that's kind of fire.
It's a fucked up cycle for me, because this is how my life goes every time I have a conversation about a show or Netflix or anything like that. I would really like to watch a show, but I'm going to watch it, and it's going to consume my life, and then I'm going to quit Netflix for 8 months, and then I'm going to do it all over again. That's what happens to me every time I watch a show. I just get addicted to it, and it's the only thing I think about. I can't do it.
Can't stop, won't stop, baby.
So it's good?
It's very good, yeah.
Jake's over here fucking slicing himself. Yo, you know this motherfucker has a knife for, like, different, like, events and outfits and shit? Like, you know how, like...
It's not entirely true.
You know how, like... No, this is true. You know how like people got like shoes?
I guess so.
That was the. Is that the fancy schmancy or is that the everyday? That's the everyday.
This is a Leatherman.
He's like,
you know how like you got a pair of shoes like Night Rock Wednesday, and then like
it's a tiny little multi.
Fucking butterfly multi, son.
Jake opened up the fucking the bottom dresser drawer and had like 12 pocket knives. I was like, bro, no way. You got like one that goes with every day of the week.
He actually do. He got ones for different events. Yeah, so I thought it was pretty interesting.
Really? No. Do you have a special knife?
No.
Well, how do you pick them? Like, there has to be a method.
You go for the vibe, you know what I mean?
So there is kind of like a...
I guess.
Some people have watches that feel the vibe. Some just really? Pocket knives.
Yeah.
Interesting.
Listen, dude, don't question the
So, like, some people have a sock drawer, you just have a knife drawer.
Yeah. I mean, it's just I got my belts in there. I got my fucking money binder in there. I keep my hats in there. Yeah. Like, it's just a general purpose drawer.
The multi-purpose
drawer.
Wait, don't we have one of those?
Not that one. Nope.
Very good.
I can't hear them. So.
I can.
There it is. That's the blue one.
I don't know why I lied. I couldn't hear those.
I can't hear them.
Brian was just digging. I heard one, but I didn't hear any other one. I'm like, I can hear all those.
Dude,
I was just
so accustomed to dick eating.
I know. That's what I'm saying. Like, what happened? Like, at what point in the friend group do we just decide one day, like, we're just going to start dick eating?
I don't know. I think it's
the natural. Day Brian came around.
Yeah. I wasn't always like this. I say this to the dad. It's because of him.
Because of who?
You.
Me.
Bro, I got bullied. I got bullied in middle school.
Oh. Who bullied you, Brian? Let's talk about it.
I didn't bully him, bro.
You bullied him?
No, I did not.
Are you a bully?
We got into a bunch of shit together. And
are you a bully?
No.
I remember that, bro. You did bully him.
Him?
Yeah.
Reese? Me and Greg did. It was like
Reese, like Reese bullied everybody.
Reese was fucking. He was
now,
different levels, call? Son.
No, you know, it was me and Joey. It was because we were the fat kids, yeah. You know. But it was also like, you know, no one else would because
fat kids, you know,
we were bigger than everyone. So
I don't know why I just thought of this now. We should do like a NSFW pod snap memory leak.
Oh yikes!
That would probably get us all.
Just a random snap memory.
Yeah, like
actually, not be fun.
That'd be cool if there's like an app that like can randomly generate like. You remember that game we played?
Skip that day.
Yeah. Photo roulette. Yeah, we played that game. Yeah. You were playing that with us too, right? Where it just randomly.
Yeah, photo roulette was lit.
That was a funny ass game. Imagine they had that like with snap memories though. That's the only reason I don't delete that nut ass app. Let me see that thing.
Thanks, man.
I feel like it's purple, but I can't really get a gauge on it.
It's black.
It's green.
No. That's their intro color.
What?
Green.
No, it's not.
It is.
No, it's not.
It is.
Are you a liar? I swear you liked blue.
He did.
You
he
always
did.
Told
everybody,
me it was
everybody goes through a blue phase, but I'm into green right now.
I don't know.
No, that's funny. I was just before you know me and him got in that conversation. I was saying that I still blue is still my favorite color, but I think I'm on the verge of it not being my favorite color.
It's funny you said that because I've recently started saying because like
pondering. You've been pondering a favorite color change.
I feel like blue is like every boy's first favorite color because it's a pretty blue. But like you know, I don't think I like I don't wear blue. Like I never wear blue.
No, it's funny because you actually said exactly what I was about to say. I've started saying like blue's my favorite color. I think like definitely in terms of just how they look.
That's like a grandfather answer though. Like I don't know if you really mean that.
No, I do. Like blue is definitely my favorite color. But what I was gonna say was black is by far my favorite color to wear.
Agreed.
So
well,
like,
but black is a shade. That's as long as I don't.
That's like fucking tomato tomato. Black's a color.
Well, it's a shade.
No, it's a color.
Is it on the rainbow?
Is the rainbow a color?
It's
filled it's
with
spectrum
colors.
Of colors.
No,
it is.
No,
I was just talking to Maddie.
Prove
about this.
It.
I don't wear like any colors really. Yeah, like, no, I wear all neutral colors. Yeah. All gray, black,
yeah,
brown.
Black, gray.
Yeah.
Fuck that.
A dark green every now and again.
Yep.
So what every is now the and best again. Color then?
I mean, it's all subjective.
No.
It's all about what you like, man.
Black.
No. Black.
Gray.
I agree. Black.
Gray? No, gray. Or no, it's gray not really. Gray's a shade too.
Gray's
right?
a No, nope, it's a color.
Shades,
he 50 almost.
Gray.
Nah, you're glazing.
No.
There's different shades of blue.
No. Gray is a shade though, because gray is made from black and white.
White, uh-huh. White through
and
black is
fucking
all
blue's
shades.
Made from what? Green and yellow?
What?
Blue's made from green and yellow or backwards? Well, am I backwards?
Oh, no.
Yeah.
Back.
Yeah.
What are you trying to prove here?
I don't know.
What happens on these episodes?
What did you bring up? What did you have written down?
I have two things. Actually,
that's a good point.
The one I think is funny, but only because, well, it's actually not funny. It's kind of sad. But, like, the person who's about is just interesting. Have you guys ever heard of a girl named Sticky Vicky?
But I am so interested in seeing this.
So in
David knows who Sticky Vicky is.
Actually, weirdly enough,
he definitely
I could
he
definitely said. Be wrong, but I actually may have bring her up on the last pod or the one before this.
Come on, this is a year field. Every time we bring up something from a previous NSFW pod, you know.
I'm pretty sure I brought it up before, I think.
Sticky Vicky.
But
I'm going there.
So give us the rundown on Stick Vic.
She was
again by saying, if you're at this point in the podcast and you have intolerance for inappropriate conversations,
skedaddle.
I'm sorry, if you're even here at this point, oh, God.
Yeah. Wait,
is this
a
big girl?
Okay.
One time for the big girl.
No, she's not a big girl.
She's a Spanish girl. Ballet dancer?
Well, ballet is one way to put it.
Hey, okay.
I think in Belladorm, she was like an event.
This lady?
Yes, but she was a stripper for like 60 years or something like that. And in Benidorm, like she would, like she was still, she actually is weird.
What is Benidorm? Like, what do you, what is that?
It's a
country. Is it a country?
I'm not sure if it's a country or it's a city inside of a country, but I know it's like a, like, you know, I mean, most people watching this probably know who the Sidemen are. Like they have like a video where they went down there. Like there was a bad team and a good team. That one spent like $100K and one spent like $100. And the $100 team had to go watch Sticky Vicky at the strip club. And they obviously couldn't show it because it's on YouTube. But like the way they talked about it, it was like kind of like an experience you have to deal with. I heard just a few months ago, Sticky Vicky retired. She like after like 65 years of stripping, she finally,
service.
Yeah, service.
The industry,
or as Kevin said, ballet dancing. 65
years in
she
the
stopped.
Field.
But sadly, she just passed away.
In the,
yeah, so it's sad, but like, just I saw it, and I thought I'd bring it up.
What is a municipality? Because it says it's a municipality in Spain. I know that that's like a location, but what does that mean? Like, is it what's different from that than like a county or a town?
I think a municipality is like a local government. Like an organized government.
It just says municipality in Spain. It's in Spain, but it's actually beautiful there. Like it actually looks fucking sick. Look, it's like a big it's a big like beach town. It looks like.
What's it called?
It's fucking sick there.
That is sick. I have one more thing. This one's net good. I don't have much information on this, but I saw like a mini article on it, and I mean I'll be honest, like I mainly just looked at it because I was looking for things to talk about. But apparently they may have found the cure for.
AIDS?
Oh, no. Not AIDS. oh my God! No chance. I forgot about it.
You forgot. Nope. What about the notes? Are they in the notes?
It's. I got you.
Come on, you note boy, your notebook. This shit look like Cartagena.
Wait, where did I see it on? Oh no, where did I see it on?
Come on, buddy. Quit the yawning. Maybe that's why you don't go on runs before podcasts.
Whatever.
What are you gonna do, right?
What are you gonna do?
It's gonna be us for the next 3 days, or it's gonna be me on Monday, actually. Fuck, Monday. I can't believe
I'm
you're doing
so it. Excited for Monday, dude.
I know, I'm ducking the pool. I'm like, fuck.
Kevin and I are getting a firm pool workout in.
I got green gills that day.
What's that going to consist of?
You know, we're going to have to figure that out. Yeah. We're going to have to see where Kev's at, you know? Okay. We're going to have to see, you know, where I'm at. I haven't swam in a while.
Yeah,
X, pull up. You should pull up, too.
You know
Monday,
what I do.
The Monday swim session. Where are you guys going?
I'm a freaking swimmer, buddy. I'm a freaking swimmer.
Are you going to the Y?
Yeah. I'm sorry, what was that? Will you repeat that?
Are you going to the Y?
Yeah. Wait.
Can't wink, really.
You can't wink?
No, I could, but it just... I don't think my winks look as good as, like, they do in the movies. Because when I wink, it looks like I'm fucking dying.
Let me get a good wink. Like, if you were risking somebody up.
Give it a... Yeah,
I don't do the wink.
Give me, like, a sexy wink.
I got a good wink, I think. But I can't do it because I'm scared.
He's scary. Give us the wink. I'm scared.
You don't actually wink at people, though. Like, have
that's
you guys ever
no, that's
used weird. The wink in a riz?
No, oh, yeah.
Have you ever used the
I'm
wink?
I'm like, yo, mom.
I feel like Xavier's be winking at girls in school. Like.
Nah, winking kind of could be the move.
The fallout guy.
Winking could be the move.
It could be the move.
It's only the move if you have a smooth wink. Also, I figured out what it was.
All right, toots.
Well, you can't say toots and then follow it up with a wink. That's like,
exactly what you do.
That's protocol.
And then you call girl toots. And
then protocol goes black and white. You sit under a lamppost and you flip a coin up and down. That's what you do. And that's the natural progression.
Yeah, and then you beat your wife when you're done, probably, right? Because that's what they were saying in those like
after
old
a three
Western
scotch
movies.
Breakfast.
Yeah, three scotch breakfast
with a pair of suspenders.
Uncle Jim's breakfast.
Nah, no suspenders. You're just hearing a wife beater, buddy.
And suspenders.
Wait, hella tobacco
and
stains.
Yes. Yeah. And a Zippo lighter in your pocket.
Bogey stains and bourbon stains.
Oh no, this is a classy gentleman.
Yeah. Nope. That's not typically. All how
right,
that
what
goes.
Do we got, B-Rone?
Whatchamacallit? So it's still like in early development, but apparently they may have found the cure for diabetes from. Apparently, they combine two treatments or two pills or something like that, treatments that are used for rare forms of cancer. And they like, use the stuff inside them, like, mix it up. And I guess it's yielding really good results.
Yeah.
It just got dropped either today or yesterday.
They
or something
just
like
dropped
that.
It. Just dropped
yeah, well, because, like, they have to drop, like, the, you know how, like, tech companies will
first
drop,
they got
to
drop the EP and then, you know.
Tech companies will drop, like, the design of, like, what they put out. So, like, then, like, other companies can use it because if they don't, it's technically, a monopoly on it. So they dropped like the basis for it so other people could look at it and then they kind of like study it. So I mean granted these people might show up missing tomorrow, but
yeah,
you know,
could very
maybe
well.
Diabetes gets cured.
No, you know something I just found out too from a podcast, if you ever have plans of like traveling to a country where like malaria is common,
mm-hmm.
don't
Agreed, yes.
Come on.
Two of like the big ones that I heard was like India, for example, and then Africa. Like both of those places.
I want to go to India. I know where to go to Africa.
All right, well, let me get to what I'm about to say. Sure. So to go to these places, like if you're a foreigner, you have to take like some kind of what the fuck was the word for it? What did I just... Malaria. You have to take some kind of malaria medicine. And apparently it's been, like, known for years to, like, drive a lot of people really crazy. And, like, you get, like, really vivid, like, hallucinations on this stuff. And apparently it's fairly common, too. Like, it's fairly common side effect of, like, taking this really popular malaria medication.
Does it have long-term effects or is it just while on the medication?
I think it might just be while on the medication. I don't know. But I'm not sure.
That's interesting. I'll have to ask Odeh about that.
I'll go nuts for a little while to avoid malaria.
How about I just take shrooms and call it a day, you know?
I mean, just trip balls and...
I got a tinkle.
You got a tinkle, dude. Yeah, I know, I got hot there for a second. I was starting to sweat that fucking heater on.
I'm going to ask Odeh about that. I wonder if he had to take anything.
Probably. Yeah. I think this thing, the stuff's called hydroxychloroquine, I'm pretty sure is what it's called.
Hydroxychloroquine.
That sounds like it'll get you fucked up.
Yeah. It's apparently for treating malaria or preventing malaria, but apparently it causes people to have, like, pretty vivid and, like, wild hallucinations that, like, lead you to do, like, crazy things. And those aren't the only things. I guess it's also been known to, it's caused, or it's been said to cause, like, people to kill other people, which is pretty crazy.
Whoa.
Yeah, like, do a lot of weird things. Apparently it makes you really aggressive. It, like, does a lot of weird things to you. That's what I heard.
Whoa.
It's pretty interesting. I don't know.
Yeah, I probably wouldn't fuck around, to be honest with you. I probably wouldn't take that risk.
Yeah, well, it's scary. Well, what do you do if you want to go to Africa?
You just don't go. Right? I mean, yeah. Honestly, in that situation, you just don't go. But it seems like, or if that's been happening for that long, they've probably...
Well, that's what they were literally saying on the pod. Like, how the fuck is it okay to still give this stuff out if it does that? But, I mean, a lot of medications are like that, though. A lot of medications have crazy side effects, but as long as they tell you the side effects, it's technically okay, right?
Technically. I'd assume it's probably more rare than it was being made out to be.
Let's see.
I'd assume. I can't imagine everyone who goes there, you know, probably has some crazy hallucinations and whatnot. That doesn't seem likely to me.
But malaria will kill you, right?
It can.
Yeah, I think so.
Treatment consists of antiparasitics. People traveling to areas where malaria is
dangerous.
It is common typically take protective drugs before, during, and after their trip. Treatment includes...
Plasmodium. What causes malaria.
Plasmodium?
And just dropped some shit.
I know.
I might be bugging.
He just said plasmodium is what causes that shit. Say it again.
Let's get a fact check.
Is malaria medication safe?
Plasmodium?
That just sounds like a spell.
What causes malaria?
Plasmodium.
Yeah, bro. I hate this.
You're
so late and I'm so tired. Like, fuck, this is my bedtime,
buddy,
bro.
I cranked a Celsius before coming here.
I cooked about 6 pounds of chicken before this.
Yeah, that'll put you.
Is that right?
I mean, I didn't eat 6 pounds of chicken. I cooked it, though.
Dang. Yeah, all right, so Anthony, do you want... I mean, you could steal Jake's mic for a second.
Professor Casper?
Professor Casper. And what'd you say it was? Plasmodium is what causes malaria?
It's a eukaryote that causes malaria.
Isn't malaria the number one cause of death, like, lifetime? I'm pretty sure.
This gets crazy.
You definitely could be right, but if I had to make a guess, I'm going to assume it's the common cold.
Let's see. I'm like, for some reason, I really think it's malaria. What?
I'm going to say
mosquitoes.
Yeah, but don't you get malaria? Yeah, I was gonna say, don't you get malaria from mosquitoes?
I'm gonna say cardiovascular disease.
Is that an actual?
Yeah, disease? Malaria. Throughout history, malaria may have killed 50 to 60 billion people, or about half of all humans that have ever lived. Tuberculosis, TB, became epidemic in Europe in the 18th and 19th centuries, showing a seasonal pattern, and is still taking place globally. No, I was just going to say, is tuberculosis and malaria the same thing? Or are they, like, I didn't think so either. Why'd they word it like that?
Tuberculosis may be a side effect of malaria.
Tuberculosis.
I requested Go Getters trivia episode.
That would be cool.
Run it.
Yeah. Run us some trivia.
Pull up the trivia questions on your phone. Maybe use ChatGPT.
We just all download Trivia Crack.
And then we could do a... Yeah. That's
honorable. You'd be a producer of the year somehow if you did it. You'd beat out... You'd beat out Xavier, and then you'd beat out Brian, probably. Brian's being producer of the year.
Oh.
If he was able to
taking your job.
If he was able to multitask the trivia and the camera angle switching, like that would be.
Let's do it.
No, honestly, first that's just a struggle, bro. When you guys be having me look up shit while also trying to keep track of you guys. That's just, all right,
Xavier, we're going trivia here.
First to how many points? Let's do first to 10 points.
You could, my phone.
All right,
my
let's way, rock.
Dyson too, but you could use mine if you
wait,
want.
Wait, not. Wait, let Ann do it because I don't trust X.
My phone's on 28. Like it'll last, but it's getting low. Is what I'm saying.
First to 10 points.
Well, we should
and
also
wait, determine who gets to answer.
We should talk for a little bit because it's going to take him time to find good questions. Like he's going to
look at ChatGPT.
I'm a ChatGPT.
Are you smarter than a go getter?
Are you smarter than a go-getter? New segment.
Are you smarter than a go getter?
Xavier, can you write this down? Timestamp it. Well, put it in your freaking notes, buddy.
I'm just saying, bro. I'm tired of the go-getters doing that shit. You know what? X should have had a notepad because they said the same shit to me when I didn't have a notepad.
Yeah, are back. You smarter than the go-getters trivia game? We're
probably.
Back. Anthony as our host.
Host Anthony. Can't see him.
What's our team name?
The Glazers. They're the Glazers.
Glazers.
Team Glazers.
They're
the Trail Glazers.
The
Trail Glazers. I like it. What are these guys going to be? These jerk-offs. Let's call them the jerk-offs. How about that?
Right. We'll be the jerk-offs.
The Brockhounds. So wait, what are we? We're the jerk-hounds and the Glazers.
The Trail Glazers.
The Trail Glazers and the jerk-hounds.
Okay, and we're off.
Casper, and we're off. Are you smarter than a go-getter?
Okay, here we go.
All right, we're going to start off with another math question. So
okay.
How many feet are there in 75 yards?
Oh fuck!
Trailblazers.
Wait.
Tell them there's a time limit here. I got it. I'm buzzing. I know it.
It's 250. It's
25.
Kevin, hold on. He said
Kevin. It's so off.
He says 70. He says 75 feet, right?
75 yards.
Yeah. How many
feet in 75?
Oh, I did it the other way around. I'm an asshole.
Order. Order.
Order.
I was right, right?
Kevin,
you
were wrong. How many feet are there in 75 yards?
75
yards.
He was wrong, I guess.
You said 75 yards?
Kevin and Jake, how many feet are there in 75?
225.
Bro, I'm a fraud.
That is correct.
I'm a fraud, bro.
That is correct.
Stop playing with the kid. Mathematician.
1-0, motherfuckers.
Am I speaking too close?
No, you're good.
Can you hear me?
Perfect. In my head, I said 25.
Derek, can you hear me?
Yeah, you're good.
You forgot another 25.
Yeah, I did it backwards the first way. I thought he said it the other way around.
What was your math? How'd you break that down?
It was just 75 times 3.
Times 3?
Yeah.
Because it's 3 feet in the yard.
I did it the other way. I divided by 3 the first time.
Attention!
Okay, here we go.
On the periodic table.
Oh, yeah. Give me this.
Which element is represented by the letter N?
Gold.
Nitrogen. Stop fucking playing with the kid.
Gold is AU, yeah.
Stop playing with the kid.
Is it 2-0?
Give me that.
That is. Correct.
All right. See? Stop playing with the kid.
Darren, what was that? You all right?
Yeah, my bad.
You good?
Can we get a host that's not dick riding?
As far as I'm concerned, he's being...
Anthony,
it's
I would...
It's 2-0. We're playing game to 10 here.
We're stick to the
side. Is it game to 10?
Yeah.
Say less. Now I'm about to really lock in.
We were talking crazy, too.
Okay. It's okay. Come back in.
I'm a big trivia guy.
What is the hardest mineral?
Diamond.
You got it.
Damn, you guys are quick, man.
That is correct.
Damn it.
Well done.
I was going to say, he just smacked the shit faster. That's what I'm about to start doing, just tapping the shit faster.
Okay. I'm about to call y'all. If y'all don't know this,
really quick, can I interrupt?
Problem.
Can you call who tapped first?
Brian. Yeah, yeah,
yeah, yeah. Like
okay,
going
so
forward,
I'll be like Brian. If you
or,
yeah,
no
yeah.
Trailblazers, Trailblazers are the jerkhounds.
jerkhounds
retain some dignity up here.
Some dignity. That's right. A good point.
Okay.
I'd be forgetting about dignity.
What would a paleontologist study?
He,
I gotta finish.
He glazed.
No.
Yeah.
Wait. No. You
he
glazed. No. Usually in trivia, if they slap before you finish your question, just stop your question.
Okay.
That's usually what they do, and then if he gets it wrong, finish the question for them. I'm good. Yo, dick rider.
What's the rule set? Somebody call it.
So, you good?
Fossils.
Yes.
He's
that is correct.
He's a glazer.
2-2? What happened?
We're going to step it up a little bit.
Step it up a notch.
In colonial America, what was the Sugar Act?
Three, two.
The banning of it was
finish
something
it.
I know.
Finish
oh
it.
Fuck! All right, hang on. It was
time, please?
The banning of pure sugar. Or no, fuck, dude, I know
can we
this.
Get time, please.
Yeah, you gotta cut that, right?
And
Damn. I'm gonna have to cut it. All right.
Brian, you seem eager to answer. Do you have something for us?
But
I don't know.
Well, which one? You can't just take all day. But I'll throw an answer out.
Banning of pure sugar cane.
Was it the banning of sugar cane and tea?
Is incorrect.
Hold on. No. Can I answer again? Can I buzz again?
No. He said
you're on my team.
No. But he said before.
You buzz, you fuck.
No. Time out. He said before he couldn't do that.
Come on, answer.
It was a tax on molasses and wine.
Oh, okay. Never mind.
It's called the T Act.
Okay.
Next question.
Well, no, there was actually a thing where it was like scientists. They like got with like lobbyist people that had a lot of money invested in like companies that had like sugar and stuff, and they banned. They banned something so that sugar could be sold more. I don't know how it went.
Here we go. Next one.
New question.
Go ahead.
Who invented the light bulb? I gotta give Kev.
Thomas Edison.
Oh, that's wrong.
Is it wrong?
Nikola Tesla.
It was Thomas Edison. Stop dictating.
The answer we were looking for was Tommy Eddie.
I was waiting for him to say the printing press.
Technically, it was Nikola Tesla.
You know what we should do? We should get a slow mo on y'all hands. Yeah.
It was a three-way tie.
We should have like a review.
3-2.
A board of reviewees. Come on, boys.
What is 14 times 5.
He's a glazer.
That's correct.
Damn. That's good.
That's actually good. I wouldn't have got it that fast.
That's actually crazy.
He is slightly acoustic. There is something going on up there. Was that a guess or did you actually like get that?
I do it like simple, like dumb but simple. I did 14 times 10 divided by 2. Because 14 times 10 is easy. 14 out of 0.
My mic real quick.
Hold on, talking your shit? Right.
As Jake was saying the other day, it's a spectrum, baby. We're all a little out of
it.
That was crazy.
Granted, also, I was kind of tight earlier that I kept getting my math questions wrong because that's the shit I'm good at. I told y'all, like, simple Brian, math is the only math I'm good at.
He took that shit to heart.
I was really tight.
He knew what you said.
All right.
Order in the court.
What score? 3-2?
3-3.
No,
we got the Tommy Eddie question.
Oh, right. Bullshit.
Tommy Eddie.
Order.
Nikola Tesla.
The Tropic of Capricorn lies in which hemisphere?
What? Eastern.
That's incorrect.
What? There's only two hemispheres. What the fuck? Oh, there is. I'm a dickhead.
My teammate thought there was two hemispheres.
No matter what, we wouldn't know.
Your teammate got three questions right.
I didn't do shit.
I gotta master a subject. Like, you're the math guy. I gotta get, like, the geography guy or something.
Geography would be a tough thing to master.
Yeah, for sure.
All right. I would request that while one team is answering, the other team is silent at risk of a penalty deduction point.
Ooh, I like that. Do we have like one like lifeline?
I wish you could see this. Yeah.
I think his tongue flew in my camera. Like, yep. I think I saw his tongue.
It's a lizard tongue. This is fucked.
Yo, can you actually put your tongue in the camera? Okay.
I gotta find a way to make his voice like the anonymous voice. Like, so here we are.
In a world.
Making his shit deep.
Attention.
Order in the court.
This is fun.
What is the plural form of the word?
Say octopus, I dare you.
Deer.
That was smooth, Cam. That was smooth, Cam.
In a dead tie, we're going to do it right now. We're going to do it right now. You won't get a chance to answer. Write it down.
You said of deer.
What if we both get it right?
The plural form of deer.
I'm going to have to give...
No points?
Go to a sudden victory.
We got a fucking quarter. Flip a quarter.
You said a plural form of deer.
Plural form of deer.
Okay.
Then you have the chance to tie, yeah. Because if you didn't tap at the same time, you would have...
Are you writing it down? I'm writing it down, right?
Oh yeah, I'm texting my.
Nah, friend. He's fucking.
Whoa! Keep an eye on Brian there.
Yeah, actually, yeah. Keep an eye on him.
Keep an eye on Brian
him
there.
Over there too. The Googlage.
I mean, my eyes don't mean much.
What's Darren up to?
He's typing.
Yeah, Darren, what are you up to? He's typing a lot.
Typing for
He already googled that shit.
No!
Look at they know it.
I need that clip.
Clip it.
And look it up at the camera like that.
I know.
That's not me, bro. Let me write it down. I got you.
You gotta do it on that page because my answer's on the back.
POV.
I would never, bro. That's never me, bro.
No, somebody clip that, please, God, and send me that.
All right. Ready? Here, coach.
Oh, wow. He actually did it successfully. His is on this page. Mine's on the back page.
Very good.
So who gets the pointage?
Team Trailblazers answered. The plural form of the word deer is?
Deer.
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 Team Brocknarks answered. The plural form of the word deer is?
The Brocknarks.
Deer. Both teams are correct. Let's no go. Point will be awarded.
No point. No point. I like that.
Yeah, I'm glad well played, that they both did it because I would have froze up and like, I don't fucking know, deer.
That's really? I'm tight.
No, I knew it, but like when I first did it, I was like, fuck, I don't know.
Ryan's a math guy. He would be like, oh, deers, doe. I'm not gonna lie. Doe.
Wait. Y'all ready? Order.
What the fuck is going on right now?
How many adjectives are in this sentence?
Mm. That's crazy. I was thinking adjective sentence. You guys know what an adjective is?
Yes.
No, wait, I forget. I smooth.
Yes, can I have silence?
I don't know.
How many adjectives are in this sentence? Billy made a rude noise in class. Team Trailblazers.
Three.
One.
That is correct.
It's one.
Yeah.
Ryan has confirmed his acousticness.
What is an adjective?
It's a describing word. So rude was the answer.
I'm so sick.
Jack Weasel. Jack Weasel.
Like, I gotta lock in.
And then I looked at him. He was like,
"Yeah, three. Where do you get score? Three?
I don't know. I just guessed. That was a guess.
Now, huh?
It's 4-3.
4-3. Yeah, because we both us.
Brocknarks. Flag marks. Yeah.
That's on 4K. Me not knowing what an adjective is.
Yeah.
That's pretty bad.
As a fucking teacher too. Check that part out. Luckily, nobody should ever see this one.
This is fun.
We should do quick intermission. Quick intermission. Give me 30 seconds.
What the fuck?
Doom, doom, doom.
A penalty.
Order.
Breaking news.
Dude, that's good.
We should all get one Huberman phone. The Brocknarks.
One Huberman phone.
With the aardvarks. So, Uncle Huberman, man. Define potassium oxide. You should have been asleep 8 hours
get
ago.
Some sleep.
I should have. Get some sleep. Polar plunge tomorrow. That shit that you told me about Tyreek Hill with the cold plunge was hilarious. I thought that shit was really funny.
Are you ready? Yes.
Which continent
uh-oh.
Is also a country?
Australia.
Team Trailblazers.
Australia.
Yeah.
Oceania.
The timing of the whole thing. I know you get excited, all of you, but let's work on the timing. In all fairness, you pointed and then... Team...
Uh-huh.
4-4.
Good job.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
It's a good one. I'm happy you got that.
Working on my...
Order! What is the longest river? Team Trailblazers.
Yeah, I know. It's the River Nile.
That is incorrect. Brocknarks. T-minus five.
Mississippi River. I don't fucking know.
The Missouri River, gentlemen.
The Missouri River. Is the longest. I
didn't even finish the question, so don't say what.
I thought he was right. That's why I just kind of guessed.
Wait, was it real? It's what is the longest river in the United States? The Missouri River,
not the Nile River. Brian.
Asshole.
That's in Egypt.
You said Mississippi. Like
no.
Did.
Well, hey, that was closer than yours.
Order! Oh, no!
I thought he was going to say the Amazon because it's technically the longest.
No, I thought he was just saying the world because it is the Nile.
No, Amazon is the longest. The Nile is the longest.
The widest.
Amazon
is the longest. The Nile is the longest. All right.
Bitch, you've seen the hand movement.
Order!
I'm happy that they can at least hear it.
Imagine like a picture of Brian like all black and white with like a quote of that underneath his Brian
Jibitz.
We should crop that. Get a picture of Brian's Tinder profile like.
Nile is the wrong.
Wait, actually, yes. Yo, if any female viewers are watching this that own Tinder, please try to find Brian's profile and please send me screenshots of his profile. I would love it.
Make that happen,
and I'd give you a shout out.
If we make that happen, we will get you a flag of it.
We will put
a flag of that in our studio.
Yes, dead ass. And we'll give you like $20 or something. We'll buy you a Dunkin' gift card or some shit. Yep. Starbucks. I don't care. Your choice. Not for you. Bitch.
I'm about to be in there on Tinder. In
a I know. I'm about to go on the.
I'm about to make a Tinder account.
Anthony.
It's actually funny. That's actually hilarious because you years ago were one of my only friends. You know what I'm about to say?
Yeah.
Somebody sent me your Tinder profile years ago.
That shit wasn't mine. I was the only time I was ever on Tinder before the age 18 was like me fucking around. I made a fake account.
That's probably what it was.
No, but it wasn't of me.
I definitely had your pictures and had your name.
I know, that's what he told me.
I probably still have that picture somewhere.
I know, he told me that.
Where.
I'm like, bro, I didn't make a fucking Tinder account.
Yo, I was thinking about this the other day because it kind of had me worried. If you just delete the Tinder app, your Tinder profile is gone, right? I hope.
No.
Really?
No, you have to. There's stuff to it.
Damn.
I'm
still out there.
Huh?
Still out there.
I guess I am still out there.
You're still swiping right on you. Is that a good thing? Is swiping right a good
thing? Yeah, that's a good thing.
But, I mean, maybe there's probably an algorithm to it. Like, maybe, like, if
you're
not active.
Are
you
glazing? I'm sorry. Let's talk about it.
I didn't think you caught on.
Let's talk about it. Sophomore. What are the shorties like down there? And I'm not even going
to
go there, actually.
Back to the trivia.
Back
to the trivia.
Order!
Order!
Quiet! Quiet! Order!
Oh, boy.
This... Can I get a noise on there? Like a dramatic noise.
It's not a dramatic noise.
A deduction for the Brocknox.
The Brocknox?
That was pretty good.
What was it?
Here,
oh, do that.
Oh,
no.
You gotta stop.
No. Second deduction. And now.
And now.
A,
that was perfect.
A double Casper point.
Oh, shit. A double Casper point.
Wait. Real quick. If someone goes in, you got to give them a countdown too.
Can we get a video? Can we get a slow mo on the
hands? No. I mean, like, some nonsense. Like, so they don't take 10 minutes to answer. It's like a 5, 4.
I will.
I'll do that before, but y'all answer too quick or too slow.
We're gonna do a 10-second countdown for this question.
Oh, that's all crazy. Right.
Video ready?
Yep.
What is the clinical name for the thigh bone? Brocknox.
The femur.
That is correct.
Damn.
Stop playing with the fucking kid, dog.
Double point, baby.
Oh, yeah, we do get two for that.
6-4.
6-4,
bitch boy.
Damn, that's treacherous. I knew that
Jake,
answer, too.
You should not be talking this much shit.
What's the greatest comeback in history?
3-1 Cavs.
How about Brady?
Edit that
Falcons,
out.
Patriots, Super Bowl.
Edit that out, the Cavs.
Oh, he's a Jordan fan. That's right.
28-3.
He thinks Jordan had a 48.
Order!
We're giving him far too much power. He's going to be doing this for like the next week and a half, probably, too.
Bro, yeah, he's going to start kicking down doors.
Jordan nor LeBron were the best basketball players.
Jordan nor LeBron?
No, neither. Kareem Abdul-Jabbar. I'm joking. I'm dick glazing right now.
I mean, he has a case.
All right, here we go. Come on. Let's go, Judge. Come on, Judge.
It's 6-4 right now. Like, my
oh, no!
Right now. Come on.
Can I get a sound real quick for them to shut them up? Good.
Now. This summer.
Sorry.
Y'all finish.
You want to do another one? Go ahead, give another one.
Hold on. Let's just rewind.
Now, this summer. I'm going to need like a longer theme for when I'm doing like my talking. And then what, you know?
We need like a doom, 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 doom.
Who painted the Mona Lisa?
Leonardo da Vinci.
He's dick sucking.
He's right.
Damn it.
He never said who entered the who.
Oh, you don't have to.
He never said the.
I knew that's what he was gonna say too, but I had no idea.
Going with like the cathedral could have been.
He'd have also been partly right there too, kind of.
Mike Ange.
Wasn't it? I think it was a couple different painters that did that.
Mike Ange, just the name attached to it.
What is the capital? Of New York City. Brian.
Yeah.
Wait. Let me take this.
Oh, hell no. Nah.
Whoa.
Wait. Syracuse.
Five.
Fuck.
He got it wrong.
He said Syracuse.
No,
I didn't.
I got it. I'm tapping. He already
Albany.
Said. No, he took a wrong guess. And I swear
Syracuse.
To God. I swear to God I was going to say that too. I put that on my fucking
he
life.
Because
we were just
That's
there.
That's crazy.
I think Brian.
I pulled it back. It was like playing a chess move.
He totally said Syracuse.
It was like playing a chess move.
No, and like
I didn't take my finger off.
I crossed my heart to die. I was gonna say Albany. Yeah, you said Syracuse.
That's no
point. No point.
No point.
No point.
I think I should get a point.
I should get a point for that.
But you know that I knew it. Like I was literally gonna say it, and you said it anyways. I told you not to.
It's me.
That's so crazy.
Yeah,
I told him not to say it because I knew it. I was like, bro, don't say it. I'm tapping it. And he said it anyways. And I,
after
like
he said Syracuse.
I put it on my life. I knew what it was. Bro, but I was tapping the table. I know, but, like, that's crazy. But I couldn't. Because
he was still counting for him.
Here. Yeah. Ball, don't lie. Just after rock, he said Syracuse. If you win, you get a point. If he wins,
all right,
you just
that's
don't
fair.
Get a point. We don't get a point no matter what.
Yeah, sure.
We don't get a point no matter what.
Ah, see? Ball, don't lie.
7-4.
7-4.
I promise, bro. Like I said, huh?
We just got the mic on for the
Leonardo DiCaprio. Bro, I put that on your life.
Wait, real quick. Order. I was going to pass the mic to them, but everyone was yelling, and it clarified that Darian was right when he said Albany. So if everyone would be quiet when someone else is answering, no offense to anybody, I could have just passed it to you, and you would have said the right answer, and that would have solved itself.
I started making noise when after he said Syracuse.
I was even, was like a chip.
I did that too.
If we take the tape back, I'm like a baboon in the back. Like, I was like, so I'm just worse than it. That was for everybody.
And we should be better.
About to kill somebody.
We got to do better. This is why you can't have any competition that involves these people in this room.
Damn, I'm a dickhead. I knew it was like a suburban New York.
Yeah.
And I was like, not Syracuse. And I'm not going to lie, I didn't fully say it. I said, Syracuse.
I heard that shit. But I knew you knew what it was, too. And I know you knew that I knew what it was.
The great podcast fumble.
Order! My brothers better know this.
We were just there.
Don't worry, baby. I do.
Come on, brother.
Come on.
I live in Albany part time.
Don't make me start stepping, dog.
Kev, get ready.
Dude, I got like 7.
Score? Oh, wait. What are we playing to?
10.
Oh,
all right.
7-5.
When did they get their fifth point? I'm a little on the. I'm on the. I'm on the. Oh, all right. Scoreboard.
That's crazy.
I'm an academic weapon. Scoreboard.
All right. Come on. Can I get my noise real quick so we know the deal? Good. All right, my bad. The ancient Egyptian Empire was based on which continent? Darian.
Africa.
That's correct.
I know Darian is like the
pedophile.
6'7".
And Darian is the geometry guy.
Geography.
I know it was a joke. Geometry.
What about pedophilia?
I was gonna say you should refrain from saying anything about pedophiles.
That's funny. He said my brother should know this one, so I knew it was like something.
Brian said obscene for president.
I thought he was gonna say some like. I thought he was gonna say when is Martin Luther King Day? So I was like, all right, hold on.
January 15th.
Probably cut that out.
Brian flew to Epstein's Island.
I only been there 20.
All right, 20 tough question. Tough question. Pounds. Everybody stay. This is a tough one. admittedly, this is a tough one for me. Unless you're.
Brian's got
unless
this
you're acoustic,
one
Brian got this.
Can
one.
I? What last time? My noise, real quick. My bad. I'm sorry. I lock in. Good.
Good.
If a car is traveling at 40 miles per hour.
Oh yeah.
How long will it take to go 190 miles?
Can you ask the question again?
If a car is traveling at 40 miles per hour, how long will it take to go 190 miles? Brian.
4.5 hours?
That is incorrect. Bruckner.
Damn, fuck, that's what I was going to say. 4 hours and 45 minutes.
That is correct.
Let's go. What's that?
What's that? I was going to say half because I couldn't think of a number for 0.7.
I know. But that's it was what I did. I just had to be quick with it.
Yeah.
I can't believe y'all got that, bro.
Me neither. Good shit.
Let's go. See? I do this shit. Huh?
You have all 8 points?
I think so.
Yeah.
I call y'all out on this one. Yep.
It's 8 to what, 6?
I'm about to call y'all out on this one.
8 to 6?
Because my little brother would know this. Ah, he's getting older. All right. Which of these is a mammal? A seahorse, a sea lion, or a sea urchin? Trail blazers.
This isn't my answer. I'm going to say urchin. I think sea lion is just throwing you off. I don't think it's a sea lion, but if you think otherwise.
I'm gonna guess
can we get a final answer submission on whatever you decide?
Seahorse. Oh, no, sea lion.
Submission on whatever you decide. All
right, I'll go down. Sea lion?
Final answer.
Yeah.
That is correct.
That's why I wanted to go with you.
I feel like that was
that was a little glazy.
Why?
A little glazy.
Just because you have no input for your team doesn't mean we don't.
Hey, I had that one right.
Wait, what's
right?
the score? Is it 7-8?
Yeah, they're
all right. Word. Brian, we got to come clutch
here. Down to the wire here.
Oh.
Wait, yeah, wait, real quick. While you guys are still up one, how about win by two?
No. Honorably.
Yeah, first to 10.
Win honorably.
I'm alive. Are you smarter than a go-getter? We might just have to cut the entirety of this start of this pod out. Just get rid of the whole thing and just make it this fucking game. Just this. Yo, we should. I should Kai Sinatin and boys got to do something like this.
We should. We should like make an actual game show setup.
Yeah, we should. And actually, like, get like a little like and table. Have
put Anthony in a tux. Oh,
yes, and we fucking get Anthony in. Yo,
the fish from SpongeBob going. Oh,
yo, actually, mark our words. That's a new GG video idea. Don't steal it. It's coming soon.
Oh, all right, here we go.
In America,
let's see.
Which day is Inauguration Day?
November.
Rock Knocks.
November 4th. Fuck me. I had two different numbers.
What's your final answer? Come on. Five.
November. November.
Incorrect. I think it's
Trailblazers.
I think it's either November 6th or November 14th. I think.
No, that's not my birthday. I think it's the 20th or the 15th.
Ooh, 15th might be it. Oh, fuck. Let's just throw out one.
Three.
It's either 6th or the 15th.
Two. One. You say it.
The 6th.
Of what?
November.
Oh, shit. They were close.
Is it the 10th?
No, it's January 20th.
Wait, what?
Damn.
What?
Oh, wait, no.
Wait, oh, November's when the election is, yeah, and they don't get an
inauguration. Day is when the president is.
No, I should have known that, because I was going.
Yeah, because they have to wait until the start of the new year.
I remember going to school when
I stink at trivia.
Jake's big political guy, too. Jake's a fucking frontline Republican, Jake's, buddy.
What?
Jake,
Jake,
I think I just saw Jake in the Make America Great Act.
I know, Jake's red-pilled, I thought.
All right, here we go. Come
Jake's
on,
quadruple vaxxed.
What's this? Can I get a score check?
8-7.
It's 8-7 now.
Excellent.
Wait. How does he have those two first masks?
Good.
When you hear that sound, you got to quiet up. If you hear that sound mandatory, you got to quiet up.
Quiet.
Can I get the...
One more time.
Why are the lights different colors? I just realized that.
Good. What?
Oh, I like that. Go, let's go dim. Let's go dim.
Oh, yeah, dim it for the final round.
How's it look on the cameras?
Probably terrible.
No, let's see, let's
no, it doesn't look bad. It doesn't look bad.
What, no, this is
bad. Oh, no, it looks better.
It, yeah, it does look
it looks better on God.
No damn, way.
Look at Ant. Yo, that's crazy.
I know. Now this shit. Like, yo, we really got to set one of these up, dog. Yo, the tongue.
I think it flashed the camera. I get windshield wiped in the middle camera.
Order!
I think I heard it.
How many sides does a hexagon have?
I said, you know, I got that shit first.
It was Kevin.
Okay. Brock Knocks.
Oh, wait, I'm an asshole.
I know.
Son
this.
Of a bitch.
Oh, go ahead, you said that.
Six.
Yeah, I thought.
No,
six.
No.
No, wait,
hexagon.
Silence!
I thought it was six. I thought it was six, too, but I wasn't certain, so I didn't want to say it. Go ahead.
It's the correct answer.
9-7.
Let's go.
Wait, what?
9-7. All right.
Game point.
Right.
Match point.
Look. All right.
Fucking
match point.
Ooh. You make a super hard.
Super. Yeah.
Super hard. Like.
Right, they got game point.
No, oh yeah.
It's 7-9.
Now you would know that, but like not until like you know. It's like oh, it makes sense.
I'm tired of math. Let me find a juicy one.
Wait, nah, bro, please put math back on. They're up 9-7. Please give it throw some
bones. Ooh,
bones.
Let's do a
no,
tough one.
No bones, just a tough one.
Order! All
right.
Press the button.
Good.
You jumped the gun on that one.
Jocko, what an accent.
How many countries are in Africa? Brock Knocks.
32. I don't know.
Incorrect. If Darian gets this.
He fucking
95.
That's a lot, brothers. That's almost half the countries in the world.
Incorrect.
What did you say?
95.
95 is almost half the countries 33. In the world.
I mean, I said
it's 54.
Oh wow.
Kev said 32, and I'm like, I think he's like super close.
I thought 32 was shooting it high.
Off the bat, I would know that.
Yeah, I would.
All right, no. I would. Anthony just basically said he was better than all of us. Yeah,
oh! Order. Order. Give me my theme music.
Can you stop giving him that, bro? He's going to get it. He goes,
you heard me? What are the three types of rock? Rocknarks.
Sedimentary, igneous, and metamorph something. What do you know the last one? Metamorphosis. Something like that.
What's your final answer?
Yeah, it cooked us.
No, what did he say? He said
sedimentary, igneous, and metamorphosis. Metamorphosis. I'm definitely saying it, I just can't fucking pronounce it right.
If he ain't pronounced right, man.
Nah, he is glazing. He just don't want me to win. But that is what it is. It's metamorphosis.
I'm just saying.
But he said a completely wrong answer.
Look, you glazed him.
All right, as the curator here, I'm saying it, I just can't really pronounce it right.
One more time, can we hear
it? It's igneous, sedimentary, and metamorphosis. I don't know which way you pronounce it. It's one of the three, I think. Or I'm just wrong.
Hold on, we need a vote.
Say it again?
Or not a vote, but like,
hold on. All right.
I gotta break the fourth wall real quick. We gotta discuss
this. This should be up to you and you alone. You're the curator here.
Oh, don't.
He's about to glaze me because we're about to win. You know they're about to glaze me because we're about to win.
Let's hear it.
Real quick, what are the three types of rock? Sedimentary, metamorphic, and igneous.
Come on.
So that's wrong. Metamorphosis.
It's wrong. Damn, that's crazy. I can't believe you'd say that. That's good.
You got it wrong. Bro, I'm not biased.
I'd love to win.
But it like is, I mean, whatever.
It's good. Whatever. And you did better than I would have.
I'd like to steal.
No point of even glazing. I mean, we all know who to... The real brainiac in the room is.
He got the people's champ.
I know. What you mean?
Ryan with him.
No, it's not.
Because the way he answered that, and I saw his face. I was like, he didn't answer.
Nah, he's glazing. Ooh. He's trying to make his case here. I had it. I just couldn't say it.
You were added two syllables.
Bro.
Okay. All right, tough one out of the blue. Let's see if anybody can bang this out. How many amendments are in the Bill of Rights?
10.
Brocknarks.
10.
That's wrong.
Pretty sure it's 10. The Bill of Rights.
You have a chance. The Brocknarks have taken it.
Play with the kid. The ball don't lie.
The ball.
The Bill of Rights is only 10.
The Brocknarks don't lie. The breaking news.
The Aardvarks don't lie.
The Aardvarks don't lie.
You know who the fucking big brainiac is, dog. And y'all already know. Because this is just an intro to what y'all about to see.
Applause for Kev.
When we really run this shit next time.
He beat us single-handedly.
Check this shit out.
I got one.
I won that shit with my partner against me. He told me I was wrong like 3 times when I should have been right. Bro, that shit was right. I was right. Yes, you're a lie or not.
I ain't gonna lie. Kevin was out there like his life depended on it, bro. Like, he was like,
what was your question? He was like, 10. How many amendments are in the
Bill of Rights.
All right, that's why I was confused.
There's more amendments.
Brian Googling it to fact check it.
No, because you said you were thinking of the Constitution. Yeah. You said you thought it was 12.
No.
You definitely did say you thought it was 12.
It was 27, motherfucker.
Run the clip.
Run the clip. But I knew there was more than 10.
Run that clip on him.
That's
the clip.
No one can see that.
Damn.
Stupid.
And no one can hear you. You sound stupid.
Somebody give me my theme one last time for my outro.
Anthony, hold on.
You heard me?
I got you, buddy.
Very impressed that. Hey, Kev, I thought you did great.
Good.
That's rough.
I thought it was a beautiful thing that Kevin did. post game for Kevin.
It's like.
Just went out there, gave my all.
Just remember that each and every one of y'all that clowned on me for dropping out of college and like doing these kinds of things. Just know like the things that are up here working in my mind, like my shit's like how would you say, it's like a machine. The shit works. So I know everything. I'm gonna know it all. And yeah, that's just all.
How much of that stuff did you have in your head because of what you do at school, at your work?
Honestly, no. I mean, besides like the math and stuff, like
that sedimentary one, there's no chance. That was the first thing
I just remember that. Well, literally the
I knew igneous.
What is metamorphic?
I only knew sediment.
The sedimentary one, yeah, the reason I remember that one is because, well, igneous is formed in like volcanoes and lava and shit. Sedimentary is the rocks that got like layers to it, like sandstone and stuff. And then metamorphic is, I don't know what those would be. Probably like, nah.
Different
Like, yeah, we fumbled, bro. Yeah, we
did. I don't know what metamorphic would be. Like
I'm just so mad that you stood on metamorphosis so hard.
Yeah. What? Why would you be mad about it? I was like, so
it's metamorphosis.
So now that the game, is over, all glazing aside, was that not like reasonable to say that I think I should still get a point for that? Because like I had it, I just like.
What's the big trivia
ballpark?
Jeopardy, you're not getting
that's fair.
Jeopardy. That's
fair.
You were
in the ballpark for sure, but it wasn't the right answer.
But the people knew where you were at.
Yeah, they knew what I meant. Right. So yeah. It's like,
now, granted, if it was like a conversation and we were like, bro, I don't know what you're talking about, that'd be different.
I would agree solely based off what Xavier said. If that was like Jeopardy for money, they probably wouldn't have given it to me.
Right. Excellent. We all knew you were on the right track, but it was still the wrong answer.
In the game show, I'm like, nah.
That's tough.
If it was a conversation, I was like, I don't know. That doesn't even sound like.
So now we got to do a real. So you know how they got.
That was tough.
You know.
Too.
Can I slide that mic?
You know how they got like AMP? They got like them AMP things, Xavier. We need one for us. Like, what would ours be called? Well, I guess we're the Go Getters, but the NSFW.
Brian's a bitch.
I know, but I'm saying their group is called AMP.
Jack's a bigger bitch.
Well, yeah. So would we just all be called the Go Getters, or?
Yeah.
GG Trivia.
GG
Or are you smarter than the go-getters?
Are you smarter than the go-getters?
Smarter than the go-getters.
It's funny. I was
because I'm about to say I coined that. Y'all were gonna lie. No, that clip back.
Yeah, no, I was really about to say I'm pretty sure that was said right at the beginning of this.
Are you smarter than a go-getter? It's actually so funny that that's the title you said. I was just talking to somebody and I was saying how I used to teach fifth grade and the shit that they go over and the shit that they learn is actually hard. Like there was a few times where I had to like Google something like. Before I like tried to help them figure it out because I didn't know what the hell was
the
going
best
on.
Part is it's simple shit that you think that you know. Like real quick, how many centimeters in an inch?
Not a fucking clue.
100? I don't know.
16?
10.
116, 2.54.
It's 110.
It's crazy.
Really?
Like you think you would know how many centimeters are in an inch, but when you really keep
I'm an idiot. I said 16. I'm an asshole.
I thought it was 110
that's
for
many
sure.
Inches are in a foot.
Nah, it's crazy because it's shit that you think you know, but.
Wait. 16 inches in a foot? 12.
No, it's 12. It's 12. 12. It's 12. It's 12 inches in a foot.
What is the 16 thing?
Huh?
16 ounces in a pound?
16
ounces.
There you go. Yeah.
Yo, I got to lock in, bro.
Yo.
This is crazy.
He said, nah, that's how many inches in a foot.
This is all in 4K, too.
I know.
Yeah. All of it.
Remember this, too, because Darian and I have the two same professions here, too. So.
Not really.
You guys fucking work with school kids.
His is a lot different than mine.
I sling booze for a living. I don't got to be smart.
If it was like... us having to redirect an emotionally unstable kid.
Yeah,
like,
got
I bet
that.
You
he
I would win that.
Yeah.
I would win that trivially.
I'd be like, whoa, wait, no.
Yeah.
But now the next time you're at the bar, you could be like, yo, so the other day I was down by the Susky and I found a metamorphic rock down there. You ever heard of metamorphic rock?
I found a metamorphosis rock down by the Susky.
Yo, did you
the
know
day?
That igneous rocks are formed in volcanoes? Because I was talking to my mans the other day. Yeah, I don't know. You could bust that out at the bar.
Crazy.
I get a tip.
Yeah, I'm not gonna lie, that was fun. That was a lot.
That was fun.
That was awesome. We actually got to do like a Go Getters trivia, John, and make it a video. I think that'd be actually so hard.
Yo, we have to rent like good equipment though, like actual stands with buzzers on them, and like a Promethean board.
That's gonna be like our first high budget Go Getters production. You guys are gonna see that.
Go Getters trivia.
Are you smarter than a Go Getter? Yeah,
it's funny. We can ask like random guests to join us too.
Yeah. Like phone a guest. Yeah.
Now you know who'd be nice at that shit is Otis.
Really?
Otis would be raw at that
like
shit.
Otis is nice with trivia.
That guy's chock like, full of fun facts.
I get like stage fright. Like
yeah.
I'm like, oh, fuck. Like,
I just kept getting beat on the buzzer. I knew a lot of them, but.
No, that's like, it's funny because literally what that is like when you get scared or you have like fear, you just get irrational. So like, that's like why games like that are hard. If you had like a minute to solve it, most of us probably would have got all those right. But it's just like the time frame thing. It's hard to like, oh, like I'm panicking. I don't really know what it is. And you just say an answer.
I think your body literally goes in like fight or flight in that.
Yeah. Moment.
Like your body freezes up trying to decide what the fuck to do. Then again, I mean, not me though. I'm still. That wasn't
we
right,
did
though.
Take an L, bro.
We did lose.
Kev.
Yeah, I'll be honest, bro. I'm still tight about
six sides in a hexagon, baby.
Fat ass bloat fly.
Yo. I thought that shit was a bumblebee.
Right, that being said, boys, it's getting pretty late. Are you smarter than a go-getter?
You guys want to end it there?
Probably.
Yeah.
Tell me, oh yeah,
you might
should. All right, guys, it's late as fuck. We all got to wake up pretty early tomorrow. We got a jam-packed day. So, with that being said, I mean, this might have been the most random podcast of all time. We absolutely hope you enjoy.
Even a podcast?
I mean, yeah. What would you even consider this? Let us know in the comment section below. But we're gonna run this pretty
that was
soon.
Smooth.
I gotta get better with that kind of stuff because I'm not really a one of those seasoned veteran content creators yet, I guess you could say. They just be a shameless plug-in, and they're good at it, but I'm not. Either way,
We hope you enjoyed NSFW episode, whatever it is, 8, I think. 8, 9, it's around there somewhere. I must say, though, before we end, like, these actually I think are my favorite podcast to film.
Oh, my God.
I love NSFW Plus. I always get so hyped.
I have a good time.
You weren't doing a trivia question with any other guests, all right? No.
Not the next time we do this.
Yo, on Monday, let's do it. Let's just bust out trivia.
So mad.
Have Anthony kick down the door. Silence! Order!
Just fucking hit the... there he goes. That just summons Anthony. You during a party, you just click that button. He comes up.
But Anthony just screamed from downstairs.
Order in the court. The next time we have like an authentic NSFW podcast where we're all fucked up, then we got to rerun it. And I'm like... I'm gonna be like
7,
19.
I was first.
Darian's gonna nail us in the coffin that night. But again, I said the next time we do like an authentic NSFW where we drink or do whatever, I said we gotta rerun the trivia, and I said you're gonna nail us into the coffin that night. But either way, like I said, guys, again, because I told you how to like again, so like again, either way, unlike, re-like, do what you gotta do, subscribe, share with your mother, because I love your mother, and. Dukes. Share with your Duke. Yeah, don't forget. No, actually, like, if you're watching this video right now, click share. A little SMS, John, pop up, Snapchat, Instagram, all those things. You can send it to your mom on whatever platform you choose, but send it to her on one of them.
Make sure your mom sees this.
Make sure your mom sees this. Yes, especially the NSFW episodes. But
that should be the outro of a life. That should be every video. Make sure your mom sees this.
Send this video to your mother. Like, subscribe, and share with your mother. And, yeah, we'll catch you guys in the next one. I love you guys. Peace.
Yeah.